Some who came thinking a professional career awaited them in the big cities of America ended up in backbreaking work on the vast farmlands of San Joaquin and Coachella valleys. It is a meeting of two generations, the old timers and the new immigrant professional. Their hands till the land and harvest its fruits and vegetables. Their sweat and muscular pains make California agricultural corporations rich without just shares of profits and are indentured to a life of poverty. Like the old timer who has tended and harvested grapes for the past 30 or 40 years, he too will be discarded like a worn out hoe. Today, he is young, strong, and needed. Tomorrow, he will be devoid of his strength, penniless and homeless. There are no comforts of home and family in the farms. The camp he calls home is owned by the grower. Their isolation from American society is almost total. On rare occasions, the dread of routine and weight of menial labor is punctuated by bubbled dreams of hitting the jackpot in Reno or Las Vegas, returning to the big city or the home country with a bag full of money or a fat checkbook. Of course, they come back from the escapade poorer than ever. These are men who can hold their heads high. As Carlos Bulusan, in his book, America's in the Heart, masterfully pictures their time as the bitterness of being a Filipino in this mirage of equality and opportunity. Bulusan dignifies the worker of earlier immigration waves with these words. In spite of everything that has happened to me in America, I am not sorry that I was born a Filipino. When I say Filipino, the sound cuts deep into my being. It hurts. It will take years to wipe out the sharpness of the word, to erase its notorious connotation in America. And only a great faith in some common goal can give it fullness again. I am proud that I am a Filipino. I used to be angry, to question myself. But now, I am proud. The new immigrant is somewhat better placed compared to old-timers whose only family life was at the pool room, lobby, or rooms of International Hotel in Manila town of San Francisco. Larry Leong, a veteran of the canneries, vegetable, and grape farms of America, relates his experiences as a pioneer leader of the country's farm worker movement.
40, 50 years ago, when Filipinos were allowed to come here and induced by the California employers to come and work in the fields, the state of California, we were brought here primarily to be exploited on cheap labor to where the employers could make a lot of money. Now, for the many years that we have been here, Filipinos have tried to organize themselves to the extent to try to bring about a better working condition and also to increase their wages, which are the lowest in the country. And this struggle, it was not easy for the Filipinos to develop their organization because the forces of the employers are against them. The city, the state, legislators are all against these people because of the fact that we are minorities which has different color, and that such opportunity is very hard. Eventually, we figured that in order for us really to develop the kind of vehicle that we need to use to help ourselves, we have to get involved in the political structure of this country so that we can then have an input as to the kind of legislation that needs to be passed where protection such as our right to organize is going to be invited. And also we as Filipinos in this country must have that kind of position. And we are in the process of developing this kind of posture with the new migrants coming lately from the islands who are more of the professional type and who has much better understanding of what the kinds of problems that we will face with at the moment in the United States. So we hope that this will happen very soon, that time will change and for the better for all the Filipinos in this country.